Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning in the old cookbook show. Today, we're not going to do anything from a cookbook. We're going to return to these recipe sheets, recipes from the home service division of the Boston Edison Company. And there are four recipes on each of these, and they're delineated in a way that you're supposed to pull them apart and put them into a box, into a recipe box. These were sent in by a friend of ours, a viewer. Thank you very much for sending them. And they date from the late 1930s into early 1942, and they've never been pulled apart. They were never put into a recipe box. They were left just the way they were sent out in the first place. Today we're going to do something called Skillet Meal, Italian Meatballs and Spaghetti. And I find these recipes very curious. We have done a recipe from an earlier cookbook that was kind of similar in that it was all in one pan and you cooked the spaghetti in the sauce. And I don't think a lot of people realize that this style of one pan meal goes back a long way. That people were always looking for sort of shortcuts and easier ways to cook things to take some of the drudgery out of working in the kitchen. And I think the Boston Edison Company was trying to do that with this recipe series, showing you how you could use electricity, either with refrigerators, with an electric range, with electric mixers, to kind of take that drudgery out. And I also find this recipe very interesting because it's a recipe from 80 some years ago where you cooked the spaghetti in with the sauce. You didn't cook it separately. Okay, so to recap, I put some breadcrumbs in warm milk and I've got them rehydrating. They pretty much soaked up all that milk right away. Into this bowl, I put ground beef and ground veal for the meatballs. And I'm gonna put in some salt and pepper. And I'm gonna grate in some Parmesan. And so here we have an all-in-one spaghetti dinner, skillet meal, where the spaghetti is cooked in the sauce in the pan from 80 years ago. Nothing, absolutely nothing that you see today on a magazine, on a website, on TikTok, all of these hacks that people bring up over and over, like they've just discovered something brand new. They may have discovered something brand new to them, but it's all been done before. Pretty much everything that we can think of has already been done. And this is another example of that. People figured out how to do a one-pot skillet spaghetti dinner a long time ago. Okay, so get in there with your hands and bring it all together. Now it says to form into small meatballs, but it doesn't say what size a small meatball is. I'm gonna say, maybe that's too big. Maybe about the size of a ping pong ball. And of course, wetting your hands and keeping your hands wet so that the meat doesn't stick to your fingers is always a great idea. I'm just gonna go free form. Now it says to, in a skillet on the large surface of an electric range, which I've got here, I'm supposed to melt 4 tablespoons of fat. So I've got bacon fat, because bacon fat would have been very common at this point. Let's melt 4 tablespoons. So, skillet. Skillet's a very funny word for me, a really weird word. It seems unnatural to say. It's very foreign. It's an American word. I would never in my kitchen use the word skillet. I'd never ask for a skillet. I'd ask for a fry pan, or in this case, a braiser, because I'm putting a lid on it. We need to put a lid on it later. So leave down in the comments, do you commonly call this, or a frying pan, cast iron frying pan, do you call it a skillet? Do you call a skillet a particular type of frying pan? Maybe I'm missing something, because it's not a word that I grew up with or ever used. So as soon as this comes up to temperature, I'm going to fry off our meatballs and get them browned on all sides. Okay, I think that's hot enough. Let's see. It's not too bad. So in they go. And I'll just toss these around and get them browned on all sides. It's Now, the meatballs are browned, and I think it's time to move on to the next step. I think there's too much fat in the bottom of this pan. I added 4 tablespoons of bacon grease, and then whatever fat has come out of the meatballs as I've been frying them. So I'm going to remove some, because I think that's the right thing to do. The recipe itself doesn't tell me to do it, but I think it's the right thing to do. So I'm going to pull out probably half of what's in here before I move on to the next step. I can always add some back if I need to. Okay, so the next step is to put in green pepper, which I didn't have. I have an orange pepper, chopped celery, and chopped onion. And I'm supposed to put that in and fry it up for about 5 minutes. Now, while that's sauteing, I'm going to move on to the last ingredients. And that's 3 cups of tomatoes and 2 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce. And Worcestershire sauce is something that shows up in a lot of American spaghetti recipes from this time period. It really is the only major flavoring component in this recipe. There aren't a lot of other spices and herbs. It does say to put in garlic if you want to. I'm sure a lot of people left the garlic out. So I'm supposed to put the tomatoes in. And we'll stir that around, get everything everywhere in the bottom of the pan. And then I'm supposed to put in the spaghetti and push the spaghetti down into the liquid, which might be kind of hard. Now it says to make sure that the spaghetti is immersed in the liquid, which is going to be a little bit difficult because there's not a lot of liquid here. I'm supposed to cover it, bring it to a boil, and then turn it to low to finish. I am really worried about the spaghetti clumping together. Because there's not a lot of liquid and it's all sort of in a really small space, it might get sticky. We'll see what happens. Okay. Yeah, this isn't gonna work. Not going to work. Not enough liquid from the tomatoes to make this work. So I'm going to add 1/2 cup of water. Give this another stir and put the lid back on. Let's see where that gets us. Now it tells me to put it onto a serving platter.
Ooh!
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends. Hey, Glen. I feel like that's going to ooze out the edge of your serving platter.
It is going to ooze out the edge. And grate on some Parmesan cheese. Of course, I don't have Parmesan. I've got Pecorino. Because I prefer Pecorino, I think, at this point, than Parmesan. Now, I did go back in. You saw me add 1/2 cup of extra water during the cooking. I stirred it 3 or 4 times, and I added another 1/2 cup. So, depending on...
I feel like I need to turn it this way, because all the meatballs are on this side.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I gotta tell you.
So, depending on how much spaghetti you put in, because the recipe says to use 1/2 box of spaghetti, and I researched...
What is 1/2 box?
What is 1/2 box? What is, you know, in 1942, how big was a box of spaghetti? And pretty much what I found was it probably was 2 pounds of spaghetti.
That's a lot of spaghetti.
Was a box. So, 1/2 box would be 1 pound. I put in just under 500 grams of spaghetti.
Okay, so I'm gonna split this and give it a try.
Try a meatball first.
I feel like that's almost still too big. It's a meatball.
It is a meatball.
I feel like it could have a little bit more flavor to it.
Very low on the flavor, but it's not dry.
No, it is a very...
It's not dry, and so I imagine the spaghetti tastes really good because it was cooked in the sauce for the entire time.
Oh, a little sauce.
And I mean, the sauce is a little bland because
it's got a bit of a bite to it, though. Is there vinegar in it, or?
There's Worcestershire sauce.
Oh, okay.
Worcestershire sauce is the only flavor. The only flavor. Now, I would add maybe a little bit of vinegar. And then I would throw in all of those herbs that North Americans associate with Italian food.
I don't know. I would, you know, you've got a base there that you could do anything with. So I'm
surprised. I am a little bit surprised. I'm going to have fun eating this.
Yes.
You know, easy to come together, easy to build on from this point. And it's also a one pot, all-in-one spaghetti skillet meal.
Oh, from 19?
From 1941.
Ta-da!
Nothing is new.
Not invented, not new, no.
Nothing is new. So, enjoy this. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.